And if you're a fan at all of hockey, you should know the name Marie-Philippe Poulin. She's widely known as the best player in the game.
Marie-Philippe Poulin with her first PWHL goal.
One of the most clutch scorers in all of hockey history.
She shoots and she scores. Leave it to the captain to restore the lead for Montreal.
Marie has made a career in scoring goals that result in gold medals, so much so her teammates and the media have dubbed her Captain Clutch.
A golden goal from Marie-Philippe Poulin. Captain Canada has done it.
It's her third gold medal in 12 months.
Marie-Philippe Poulin with a hat trick for Montreal.
That doesn't say Captain Clutch. I don't know what does.
And we're so happy to have Captain Clutch herself joining us here on NHL Now, getting ready for a big game against Boston tomorrow in Montreal. She is now the captain of PWHL Montreal. And as we begin Women's History Month, we're so happy to shine the spotlight on, again, the woman that is widely known as the best player in the game right now. She won't say it herself because she's so humble, but Marie, thanks so much for taking the time here for us. And as I mentioned, you're now captaining this new league, the Professional Women's Hockey League up in Montreal. What does it mean to you to be able to play professionally, a regular schedule, which is something you fought so hard to be able to create?
Oh, it's surreal right now. What's been happening since January 1st, the start of our league, and just the excitement around it. Like, you can go around the league to every game and you see little girls, little boys, the stands are filled. It's been unbelievable, and it's excitement. And obviously for myself here in Montreal, being one of the leaders on the team, it's an honor. Obviously, it's a brand new franchise. You try to create a culture to have fun, to win. But obviously, through it all, it's been unbelievable.
I asked Sarah Nurse about that up in All-Star in Toronto and just asked her about what it's like to play in the league, what her impressions of the league are, and it was really interesting. She said, hey, this is what we fought for. This is our stage. We're on our stage. What say you? I'd love to hear it from the best player in the women's game. Talk to us. Let us know.
Well, obviously, it's hard to follow after Sarah Nurse, but just the excitement. Obviously, we have fought for many years. We have sat down for years to make sure we have the right lead, the right resources to make sure it was going to be professional. And obviously, since the start with the Walter groups that came behind us, the building king, and all the support of people that believe in a product, it's been the start of something big, and it's just the start. And you can tell the excitement about women's hockey right now, women's sport in general. Obviously, we're lucky enough to be in this league, but didn't happen overnight, like we're all aware, but there's a lot of people that have been behind us for many years, and finally we're here, and it's just going to keep getting better.
Yeah, so a couple things here. I live in Minnesota, so we're fortunate to have a team there as well. And I think it's becoming, you know, you hear people talking about it more and more. And for anybody who hasn't had a chance to watch, the product is incredible. So congratulations to you guys. It really is. And I think people, I mean, Minnesota's a big hockey place, but you can hear the talk starting to build about needing to go watch these girls play hockey, because it really is incredible. So anyway, my question for you is, being one of the best players, being around for a long time, a leader, how much were you involved in getting this together? And we'll get into the there's some cool rules in this league as well, but that we'll get into later. But how involved were you in getting all this together, putting those new rules in, kind of how it's going to work? Were you fronting this whole thing?
Obviously, we had a great board. Players have been on the board, Hillary Knight, Kendall Coyne, Sarah Nurse, Breanne Jenner, Liz Knox, and those are the main player that really will get us on calls and have our feedback of where we're going. Obviously, they were our queens there that really went on many calls for all of us. They sat down hours and hours to make sure this league was going to be set up. And obviously, we're all in it together. Since the CWHL folded, we obviously took a pause. We were in those showcases where we're traveling a little bit across the U.S., Canada, to reach out different communities. But nothing was even close to where we're at right now. So obviously, that board really put a lot of hours to make sure this was going to be in it. And we're a big thank you to them, because they're a big reason why we're here.
And it's an ongoing process, right? In fact, just this week, we found out that the new inaugural playoff format was introduced, as well as the whole draft format, too. And so kind of to get people who might be watching up to speed, here's a couple bullet points. So there's six teams total, right? The top four are going to make the playoffs. The first place team is going to be able to choose who they play between the third and fourth place teams. So possibly some bulletin board material there. And it's going to be a best of five series throughout. And then going further, the teams that are eliminated are actually going to take on what's called the gold plan. And it's this idea that you still want to win down the stretch, even if you're eliminated from playoff contention, because then you can ensure that you get the top pick in the draft. Here it is. And this is an idea that's actually been kicked around in NHL circles as well. So it's kind of to try to eliminate tanking, right? You don't just want to tank to get the first pick in the draft. So, Marie, I'm just curious to hear your thoughts to the news in terms of the whole picking your opponent if you guys end up being the first place team, and also this whole draft selection process.
Yeah, all of it's exciting. I think I forgot to mention Sanders right away on the board. She's been doing amazing. But with those rules, I think it's unbelievable. I think it just shows that every game really matters. Obviously, it's a short season. We have 24 games. And everybody's still in it, like, easily. Like, obviously, right now you see Ottawa, New York, but with one game, they're right back to the top. So that's the amazing part of this season. And with all these new rules, obviously, the jailbreaking is unbelievable. I think it makes the PK with a lot of pressure on the power play, which is pretty cool. But obviously, in terms of playoffs, you can tell anything can happen. And obviously, in season, you can be at the top. But when playoffs happen, it's another new season. And whoever you're going to play, it's going to happen. You can be fourth, third, second. I think at the end of the day, it's going to be a battle, and it's the fun of it. You want to play best on best, and obviously every game matters. And until the end, even if you don't do the playoff, you still have something to look forward to, which is that first pick overall.
Yeah, that's a really good concept. I love that. And Marie, listen, you know, I know that this all came together, and there's so much work on behalf of your board and all the ladies and people that were involved to even make this launch as successful as it's been. But I also like kind of the fashion side of things. So have you seen any of the new jerseys that are going to be coming out for next year? I know it was tough to get them this season, but have you had a chance to see what the jerseys could look like going forward? Because there's a lot of us that want to buy the merch.
I actually have not seen it yet. I think there's a lot of our work that's being done right now to make sure we're going to have names, different colors, and everything. But let me tell you, there's a lot of work that's being done behind closed door to make sure that we keep getting better as a whole, as a group, and just this whole league getting better. But obviously right now it's been unbelievable and surreal to be able to play for myself, Montreal, but all across the league. I think I can tell you the girls that been waiting to be part of this league to finally put a jersey on. There's a lot of pride, honor right there.
You know, I thought Weeksy was going to go more with the walk-ins, because that's
the walk-ins are fun, but that's my point.
Thing, like, in the fashion world, right? Like, that's kind of cool. We see pro athletes across men's and women's sports with their walk-in look, their fit, if you will. Yeah. And I know that a lot of the women have been really enjoying
showing up
their game day fits. Is that something that you've enjoyed as well?
Yes, 100%. I think, obviously, a lot of the fan base gets to know us as hockey players, but I think when you get to connect a little bit on the personal side, you can see how we dress, how people get excited about it. And it's part of the routine now. You get ready for a game, into the shower, you're picking your outfit to look good for obviously that walk-in picture, and obviously gets you ready for the game. So this is very fun, and it's been awesome to get to know other players and how they dress and how they look good.
All right, I mentioned a little earlier with the couple different rules that you guys came up with, and they're pretty cool. And correct me if there's more than one. I know it's a 3-point rule, so for anybody who doesn't know, it's 3 points for a regulation win, 2 and 1, 2 for an overtime or shootout, 1 for overtime loss. But talk to us about the jailbreak, because this is a very interesting rule that I think is very interesting to look at for the NHL. I think it's an awesome rule. So explain to the viewers the jailbreak rule.
Yes, I love this one too. I think it's so exciting. Like I mentioned a little bit earlier, obviously you have that power play, excited to get that 2 minute on. And obviously if that power play doesn't work and that PK, that's that puck, and gets it and get a goal, that penalty is canceled and you get back to 5-on-5. And I think it does make sense. If that power play doesn't do well, that PK gets rewarded and you get back to 5-on-5. And obviously, as a PK, I think it changed as well. You don't just sit down, you sit back and just, I think you pressure the power play even more and you take some chances as well. And obviously, I think it creates even more. You can see a couple this year already jailbreaking, and it's been fun. You get back to 5-on-5 and you got a goal. So, but I think it does put pressure on the power play as well to do well and be ready to go. So in both ways, I think it's awesome and it makes the game quicker even.
Marie, you've done just about everything in what is certainly going to be a Hockey Hall of Fame mm-hmm. career for you. You're actually the only player, male or female, to score in 4 gold medal games. I mean, it's ridiculous. We know all about you being named Captain Clutch, but I guess my question to you is kind of where recent experiences rank for you. In so many great experiences, you just played in this whole battle on Bay Street, which for those people who don't know, it was Montreal and Toronto playing at Scotiabank Arena. Mm-hmm. Sellout crowd. It sold out in like 2 hours, and yeah. I think the final attendance was like 19,200 something. You guys are going to play in the Pittsburgh Penguins rink in a couple weeks and takeover weekends. So that'll be awesome. So in the past few weeks, what has that been like to you? Where do those experiences rank in terms of seeing the women's game being received so well in terms of attendance numbers?
All right, it's up there. I think the last month since the league has started, it's been very exciting. And obviously, I've been lucky enough to be part of the national team, to be part of the Olympics. But when you're part of this, when you work so many years to make that happen, and finally it's becoming real, it's so exciting. It's so fun. So those experiences, for sure, they're going up. And like you mentioned, the Battle of the Bay, pack out, like it was packed, the amount of people that was in there. And it's just when you go outside and people are talking about it, you feel the excitement and how they're just telling you, finally, we're here, we're watching women's hockey. And obviously, it's been years in the making. We've been working hard to make that happen. And now we hope that it becomes the norm, that people are excited to come and watch us. It's been, like I mentioned, it's been a long time coming, but to see these rinks filled up with kids, with family, with hockey fans, and it's just been surreal, and we want to keep going and want to make it the norm and making fun.
Okay, so you've got all these gold medals. You got 129 gold medals, okay, which is amazing. I know I'm exaggerating, but no, that's awesome, and we love that, and congrats to that. But here's the thing, from your perspective and your mind's eye, where do you see the league in the next 2 years? Because you're off to such a great start as a league right now.
Yeah, I think to just keep sustaining it. Obviously, we will want to grow. We want to grow. We want to expand different teams. But I think right now, maybe obviously in terms of capacity, in terms of rink, we can grow even more. I think in terms of, we talk about Montreal, Toronto, we have rinks here that can allow us 2,000 to 4,000 people. And I think we can see we can maybe move to a little bigger arena. But I think sustaining that, having more visibility, seeing more on TV, talking about it even more, and eventually expand and have more teams. Because obviously there's a lot of college players graduating, wanting to be part of this thing, which is amazing. And that, we want more players, which means more teams.
You know, I've heard some really moving stories from some of the women playing where, you know, it's just really cool to hear from other girls or even little boys, too, about how awesome it is that women now have an option to play professionally, which was not really a sustainable thing before this new league. Have you had any really cool moments of young players coming up to you or saying, I want to be just like you, or I want to play in the PWHL someday?
Yeah, I've been pretty awesome to see the amount of little girls coming up and even parents coming up and seeing us. And finally, our little girl can dream to be part of this league. And those are the moments. And those are moments that reminds you why we're doing it, why we've been fighting for to have these little girls want to be part of this league. And also boys, also older boys actually acknowledge it and actually knowing who we are. And I think that makes a big difference when there's little girls playing in boys hockey. You know what? They're the same. They play the same sport, and one can dream to be part of the NHL, one can dream to be part of the PWHL. And this is surreal. And also, the older generation. For me, also, is very special because I've had the chance to play with many older players that was that wish and dreamt to be part of a professional hockey league. And now they're seeing it, and when they talk about it, you can see how proud they are. And just to see that, I mean, it goes a long way, and it means a lot.
Well, it's been really awesome to see everything that's happened so far to this point. And we certainly thank you for your time and insight here today. And go keep crushing it on the ice because it's so fun to watch night in and night out.
Thank you so much, guys.